Friends, you may be well aware about the Karnataka ketchup or Karnataka conundrum, where Kumaraswamy ultimately has to step down as the chief minister, having ruled the state for about 14 months or so. You have also seen so many twists and turns, just like a suspense thriller, and ultimately it has come to an end. So what we want to tell you is more about the constitutional provisions and legal provisions, and also a little bit political issues involved in this particular event. So you may be well aware that the Karnataka Assembly has got 224 plus one nominated MLAs, right, out of whom 105 they belong to BJP, the rest of them belong to the coalition, that is JDS and Congress. So on 10th of this month, these people, some of them, they have resigned, and the trouble started from the time onwards. So ultimately, what happened, okay, about 10 days back it happened, ultimately some people resigned, and they stated that they have taken the decision of resigning from the party, and they sent the resignations to the speaker. Now this issue relates to the powers of the speaker and as well as the powers of the governor also. So when they gave the resignations, the speaker has kept cool over the matter, and the people have gone to the Supreme Court also. So according to the Article 190, Clause 3, Subclass B of the Constitution of India, a leverage is given to the speaker to inquire into the matter whenever a party member, whenever an MLA submits his resignation, to verify whether it is voluntary and genuine. Of course, the reading of 190 says resignation, if it reaches the speaker, it is deemed to have been resigned, that's all. But still, during the year 1974, 33rd amendment has come, wherein it has been stated that actually it is having a checking mechanism, rational checking by the speaker, to avoid the so-called coercive resignations. There were occasions, you may be knowing why Rajiv Gandhi introduced this anti-defection law in the year 1985. And previously, when the Haryana government was formed in 1966 or so, IRAM, Gayaram theory, ultimately anti-defection law came only for that purpose. Today one MLA is in this party, tomorrow is in another party. And to avoid all these things, actually Rajiv Gandhi brought that anti-defection law. Of course, now people, the politicians know how to circumvent the anti-defection law. We have seen just within 2 months, very recently, four MPs of Rajya Sabha, four MPs of TDP out of six, they switched over to the BJP and merged with the BJP. And second incident is these 13 or 15 people resigned from the JDS coalition. You may be knowing the number, I told you, for that reason only, 225. Why this 15? Suppose 225 minus 15, then 210. Out of 210, how many? 105. So 105 BJP members are already there. That's why they have these 15 members resigned only for that purpose. Right? Everybody knows it. Anyway, so it is the, of course, every elected member has got the authority to switch over to the parties, we can't expect, but it will be taken as a defection under anti-defection law. If he voluntarily gives up his membership, then it is called defection. It was decided in Supreme Court, so many cases, Ravi S. Naik versus CNF India. It is very clearly stated that if the member abstains for voting when whip is granted, it is actually treated as defection. So many judgments are there. Now, the speaker did not decide on the matter because he wanted to verify, or he wanted to inquire whether the resignation is voluntary or genuine. So when talking about 33rd Amendment, I have to tell you that 33rd Amendment came only for the purpose of as a safety mechanism, and now the Speaker is authorized, he is empowered to inquire into the matter, and he has to satisfy himself that this resignation is voluntary and genuine. It takes time. In the meanwhile, these defected MLAs or the MLAs who resigned, they went to the Supreme Court and tapped the doors of the Supreme Court, leveling allegations against the Speaker that he is not accepting their resignations and things like that. But Supreme Court, it has given liberty to the Speaker and freedom to the MLAs. In the meanwhile, the government, what has done is the party in power, they wanted to move the trust motion. Please remember, trust motion or confidence motion will be by the government in power. No confidence motion will be the opposition parties. Normally it will be done. So why trust motion? Because they wanted to give a whiff. Whiff, you may be knowing, when once any member denies or it does not follow the whip, they will be suspended, their MLAship is gone. So now a constitutional crisis come, whereas the Supreme Court said, yes, we cannot ask the Speaker to hasten up the matter or to fix a limited period for his inquiry because it is a prerogative. Similarly, we can't ask the MLAs who resigned to participate, basing on the whip, to participate in the trust motion. So then another chaos has come and it was not decided. Of course, the party in power, they say that they have waited for some time. Of course, Speaker being their man, he actually supported them some time. In the meanwhile, what happened is the governor sent a message that trust vote motion should be done by the next day. 2 days back, he said, tomorrow you have to do it. But the Speaker did not interfere. Of course, Article 165 of the Constitution of India says the governor can interfere in the matters and can advise. He can advise the government. Of course, just let us go back to another article. Article 164, Clause 2 says about the collective responsibility of the state, that the ministry is collectively responsible to the governor. Of course, the provisions are there, but if you follow, it's okay. If you don't follow, nobody can do anything. You may, even though governor's post is a gubernatorial post, how people are performing the so-called impartial duties, you are all well aware. I need not reiterate because situation has come to from bad to worse. Vajubhai, everybody is doing like that only. We can't help it anyway. So he interfered once, second day also interfered, and ultimately it was decided that the trust motion should be held by Monday evening. Right? Okay, still Kumar Swami, he wanted some more time. The party in power, even the Speaker is vexed. He said, no, at any cost, we have to hold the trust motion. So it was held, and ultimately, of course, the party persons who resigned, they abstained as usual. 204 persons, MLAs were present, out of whom 99 voted in favor of Kumar Swami, and the rest 105 voted for the BJP, due to which Kumar Swami has to step down. So why I am telling all this see the drama. They are circumventing the anti-defection law. The very purpose of anti-defection law is that, if you want to change from one party, elected party, to the other party, better you resign, go for elections, get elected, nobody will observe. But how much money, government money, is wasted? For election process, very recently, we had the election process and they spent so many crores of rupees. For electing an MLA, it's not that easy. Of course, he has also spent so much of amount. It is another aspect, but legally, to be frankly saying, so it is a much cumbersome and experience. It has so much of effect on the state exchequer. To avoid that only, all these things, anti-defection law, IRM, the IRM principle, have been initiated by the Rajiv Gandhi government. No, I don't know where. So 1985 or so it happened. But the privilege given to the Speaker is, they did not mention any time bound, any time frame. If the time frame were to be there, now it would not have happened. So Speaker says, He has to make up his mind. He has to take a decision. We don't know when he will take a decision. Ultimately, anyway, since the some of the MLAs also once again contested the so-called resignation, and they applied for the so-called trust motion not to be held before the Supreme Court. Of course, Supreme Court did not come. Of course, what Supreme Court did is only advise the Speaker to hasten up the matter, and the Speaker said on behalf of him, the advocate who appeared, he said that Speaker will take a decision at the appropriate time. You may be knowing very famous lawyers, Rajiv Dhawan and Abhishek Mansingi, all these people appear before the Supreme Court. Of course, Supreme Court said it has given, it has given liberty to the Speaker and freedom to the MLAs. They cannot say. Supreme Court said we cannot force them to go and obey the so-called whip. They already resigned. Now, what is the use? The Congress people, they have immediately commented, what is the use of giving whip? It's a waste. So, if once whip is given, they have to abide by it. If they don't abide, what is the value of whip? They discussed ultimately, of course, they abstained and everything went on. Now, Kumaraswamy has stepped down. We are all well aware that Mr. Yediyurappa will take charge tomorrow then. So, please remember the constitutional provisions of 190, 164 and 165. Read them thoroughly and enrich knowledge. And where the point I want to tell you is trust motion by government in power, no confidence motion by the opposition parties, and also it has to be moved only in the assembly, because Karnataka has got the so-called MLCs also, it has moved in the assembly. Please remember these things and enrich your knowledge. Thank you.